Next, we're going to hear from Avneesh Singh, who is chair of the W3C Accessibility Task Force and brings his deep knowledge of web standards and their role in addressing the inaccessibility crisis and research outputs. Thank you, Avneesh.
Thank you very much. So as Shamshi mentioned, I am the Chief of Strategy and Operations DESI Consortium, and I am on the advisory board of W3C. And as she mentioned, I'm chairing the accessibility task forces for publishing at W3C. Let's start with my presentation, which is all about accessibility standards, which are the prerequisite for accessible reading. Let's move to the first slide. Why I say that accessibility standards are so important for accessibility? Well, the accessibility is the result of good interaction between the three components. One is the content, then other one is the rendering software or the user agent that displays this content with support of the accessibility layer of the operating system. And third piece is the assistive technology. This can be represented by three people sitting around a table here in the photograph, and they are interacting with each other. Just tell me, what is the most important thing that these three people need to interact? You are right. They need to know the same language for interacting with each other. In the same way, the three components that I mentioned, the content, the rendering software, and the assistive technology need a uniform, a common language to talk to each other. And this common language is accessibility standards. So this is why accessibility standards are so important. The content document need to expose the content adhering to the accessibility standard. The user agent or the rendering engine need to recognize this and expose the accessibility controls to the assistive technology. And the assistive technology need to understand this and then transform it into Braille through into the speech, or maybe in other modes of communication. So you may be thinking, that's great. Now we know that accessibility standards are so important. It validates our assumption. Now let's get together and start creating a great accessibility standard for specialized for research papers. That's a great idea, but there are some issues there. Before we jump into it, I would like to show you another photograph. Here is a photograph of the different electric standards used in different parts of the world. In America, we have the two strips. In Europe, we have the two pins. And in India, we have the different standard. In Europe, in UK, we have the different standard. So all of us global travelers know that it has been a pain for us in the past to make our devices work with the electrical supply of the destination country. What if the whole world starts using the same electricity standards throughout the world? Well, this is the exact problem that we would face if we create a specialized accessibility standard for one domain, one specific domain. So it is very important that we leverage the international standards, existing international standards, instead of creating our own standard, because we will face a lot of issues related to interoperability across the different parts of the world, challenges across the different platforms, and also across different assistive technologies. Now let me list down the most popular international standards for accessibility. Let's start from Unicode. Unicode is not an international standard for accessibility, but it's an international standard for ensuring encoding. It is so important for accessibility because your assistive technology will not be able to understand the non-Unicode font, especially if you are writing your papers in non-English languages. Now let's talk about the web technologies, HTML and CSS. We have the famous WCAG and ARIA specification for these. For EPUB 3 publications, we have EPUB accessibility and discoverability requirements. For PDF, we have PDF/UA, the ISO 14289 specification. And for the highly specialized libraries, we have the NC NISO Z3986, which is popularly named as the DAISY standard. Now I will also like to focus something which is very important for research paper. It is the scientific, technical, engineering, and mathematical content, the STEM content. As you know, the research paper are all around the STEM content. I would like to focus on mainly two pieces at this point of time, for which a lot of work has been done in the past, and we have seen revolutionary changes recently. One is accessible math. We have heard how we have been using the plain math, the LaTeX, and MathML for making the math accessible. MathML was always based on XML. It is a decade old standard, but we couldn't utilize this high potential candidate for accessible math because we never had good implementations. We used to rely on the third-party products like MathJax for rendering MathML. But everything changed in 2023. In January 2023, Chrome started supporting MathML natively. And because Edge is based on Chromium platform, so now Edge also supports MathML natively. Firefox and WebKit already supported MathML. So with this, we have very good support for MathML across different browsers, across the platforms. In fact, in DAISY consortium, we have created best practices for authoring MathML, and I have provided the link to these best practices in this slide. And we will be revising these best practices in 2 or 3 months timeframe to make it aligned with the latest native support of MathML in Chrome. The other important piece is extended descriptions. This was also a big topic of debate in the standards community. Finally, the HTML5 working group settled on the HTML detail element for showing the standard descriptions. So the main question was, how can we show extended description without disrupting the reading flow for a person who doesn't need it? So this is an expandable element, the HTML details. A sighted person who doesn't need extended description can go through the image and skip this control and move ahead. But a person with a disability can click or activate the details element, and immediately it will expand and show the extended descriptions in the text form. So we have developed the best practices for authoring extended descriptions also. There are 2 or 3 techniques in it. And here is the link of the DAISY consortium document in which we do so. Now let's move to the next slide, where I'm trying to answer another very important question. You may be thinking that it's great, we have the existing international standards that we should be leveraging, but there are always very specific requirements which are very specific to a domain. How should we incorporate these? I would like to put forward the case study of EPUB 3. When we started working on the EPUB 3 specifications, we decided to leverage the XHTML5, which is the mainstream specification. And we decided on the principle that we will be using the mainstream, the existing international standards to extend possible. And for the very specific requirements of digital publishing, we customized or we added an attribute named as EPUB type. Now, how did it work? A web browser who is not aware of this EPUB type attribute will just ignore it and show the XHTML page as a web page. On the other hand, an EPUB 3 reading system, which is aware of this EPUB type attribute, will read it and provide the specialized digital publishing behavior with its help. So this was the first step. The second step is that we should get all these workarounds, all the short-term solutions integrated with the international standards. So we worked with W3C, we worked with the HTML group, and the ARIA working group in W3C, And now all these values of EPUB type are incorporated in the ARIA specification as DPUB ARIA module 1.1. So this is how we can work with international standards and we can customize it for short-term solution. And then we can get all the requirements back into the international standards by working closely with these international standards bodies. Now I would like to move to the last slide and would like to say that we are in a revolutionary times. We have a great opportunity in hand for creating the universal standards for accessibility for the research papers. So let's come together for the common international standards for achieving accessibility. Thank you very much.